A lot of prospective clients really like to see what our audit reports look like. They want to know what they can expect when they get back their report. But I don't share audit reports from other clients, and really, I don't share any of our client information whatsoever. So you're likely not going to see any company logos on accessible.org. And unless someone offers, you're not going to see a testimonial. A client testimonial on accessible.org either. And that is because that's for multiple reasons. One reason is I wouldn't want that if I was a client. Another reason is this is an ultra litigious landscape. So I'm not going to share or volunteer client information. Also, I don't think that's owed to me by my clients. I don't think clients owe me a testimonial because they hired me. That's not the way accessible.org is run. So it's likely that you won't find any of that information, and you're not going to get an audit that we've completed for another client. But what you will get right now is me going over what you can expect when you get an audit from accessible.org. So on the screen with me is an Excel spreadsheet, and we have this cover page, which includes all of the URLs that are within the scope of this audit. So these URLs are information from accessible.org, and it's not even the correct information. So really, I've just put placeholder URLs and placeholder page titles so that you have an idea that this is what is included in your audit. So just the cover page, it's just a nice cover page that includes the full scope of the audit. So what is contained in this report? Well, it is an audit for all of these individual URLs. And so we have the standards. We have WCAG 2.1. 2.0 is obviously included in 2.1. Then we have conformance levels A and AA included. And then so moving on to the next worksheet, we get into the audit itself. And again, this is placeholder information. This isn't actually an audit, but it will give you a really good sense of what you can expect. So I'm not going to go over all of the details here because we've got 19 rows of information. But what I am going to do is tell you all of the different columns that are contained in this audit and the information that you can expect. So we have issue one as the first row, and then we have number one, and then so on down the line. Then the next column is location. So in this case, we have footer. Then we have page URL. Again, I've included accessible.org as the placeholder. And then we have environments. So we have Windows, Chrome, and NVDA listed here. The next column is the issue. So in the issue column, this is the most important column in the audit report because we detail here exactly what accessibility issue exists on this URL that we've already named. So it's going to go into as much detail as is necessary to describe fully what the accessibility issue is. And then moving on to the next column, we have the applicable code. And this is important because the developer or whoever is working on remediation will be able to quickly identify where the issue resides in the code. And then on the next column, we have the WCAG success criterion. So what is the actual accessibility issue in question? And then we have another column on users affected. So what type of disabilities are involved with this accessibility issue? And then we have a recommendation column. And this is another very important column because we provide a recommendation on exactly how to fix this accessibility issue. And where applicable, and many times it's going to include a code example for your developer to work from. So there's really, it leads the person who is remediating the issue, it leads them to exactly what type of code would be appropriate in this circumstance. Obviously, this is only a recommendation, but it will give anybody who is working on the audit a really good feel for how to remediate this issue. And it's not always going to be a code issue, but our recommendation is going to be what we would do to fix this issue. So really important column there. Another really nice column is this next one, which has screenshot. So if it's a screenshot, then it's going to be an actual screenshot of the issue found on your website. If it's a clip, so if it's a screen recording, that might also be here. So you might have a link to a recording of the issue, and this might be us demonstrating the issue. But either way, it's another way to learn more about the issue in question. And then the last column is notes. So for any additional information that wouldn't be included in the previous columns, then we have a notes column where we're going to provide any relevant information. So this may be on fixing the issue. This may be on best practices. This may be on something that was additional to the actual issue itself. So maybe further description, whatever it is. With our audits, we want to make sure that we provide as much information as possible to help our clients take action upon our audits, because that's really the most important part here, is that the audit is actionable. We want the report to be actionable. So that means that we have clear and understandable information and actionable information that our clients can they can proactively work through the audit, and they can take action on our website. So not on our website, on our audit. So the audit report is very detailed. It's very thorough. And that's getting at the point of the audit is we want to have a fully manual, formal evaluation of the website. And we want to bring forward all of the issues, and we want to be as detailed as possible. So our audits are very thorough, they're very detailed, and they are designed to help you, our client, take action on the audit. So if you are in need of an audit, I will include more information in the description, or you can go directly to accessible.org and contact me or find out more about our audits in our services section. So I will include more information in this video's description, but you can also go to accessible.org.